Hi, I Prabodh Mahajan welcome you all in C programming. In this video we will be learning what is case control structure, that is switch case, the switch case versus if else ladder, means basically the difference between the switch case versus the if else ladder. Okay, so also we will be discussing what the two keyword is and what is the function of it in C program and typically in case and in looping and in statements. Okay, so at the end of this session we will be discussing the summary, and finally I will be giving you some programs that you must practice in order to enhance your knowledge of C. Okay, so let's firstly see what the case control structure is. So the decision using switch means switch case statement. Okay, it is also a kind of statement in C. So the control statement that allows us to make a decision from the number of choices is called a switch, or more correctly a switch case default. Okay, since this is a sequence. Okay, since these three keywords go together to make up the control structure, which is switch case control structure. Okay, so this is the syntax which can be given by switch. Switch is a keyword, switch, and then in parenthesis integer and expression. Okay, so what is integer, what is expression, I will tell you by taking the help of program. Okay, so this is a case constant one. Do this, suppose if you want to print quiz or if you want to develop a quiz, then you can simply make use of switch statement. Okay, so this is gonna be helpful for you. So the integer expression following the keyword switch is any C expression that will yield an integer value. Okay, I repeat, it will yield an integer value. So this is a sample program which tells that write a program to determine whether an entered character is vowel or not. Simply vowels means A, E, I, O, U in English language, right? Yeah, so let's start it. We have defined here character data type having name CH. Okay, then printf as an output which tells you, or the programmer, okay, which tells that enter any character. Okay, so scanf for input function to give you a perfect output. Okay, so percent c means for character, as I told you earlier, the format specifier for character is percent c, and as we are dealing with the memory location in which the ch is stored, so we have used here ampersand. Okay, so these integer constant, as I told you earlier, so switch, these name is here switch ch. Okay, so in curly braces the case a is there, means a here you see e, here you see I, here o, and here u. Simply you must 75% aware of what this gonna be going and how this gonna be going. Okay, so these simply printf, if case a, if you enter capital A or small a, since this is character type, we have given a single colon, single inverted commas, right? So printf percent c is a vowel, percent c, why? Because this is character, and this indicates that ch, means ch is a name of character data type. Okay, so similarly for e, similarly for I, similarly for o and u. Okay, and please listen here, this is the break. So that the statement will be not continue, as we have studied the break keyword, the continue keyword, okay, in previous slides. Okay, so one more thing is there, if you enter the value rather than capital A E I O U or small A E I O U, then the default block, as you see here, it will be executed, and it will say that entered value is not a vowel. Okay, and return 0 will terminate and terminate the program. So this is the output which tells enter any character. So we entered here A, so this gives A is a vowel, right? So let's see the difference between the switch versus if else ladder. What is the actual difference between the it? So a float expression cannot be tested using a switch. Okay, as I told you earlier that we are studying integer expression. Okay, so cases can never have variable expression, means they could not be changed. So for example, it is wrong to say case a plus 3 and then colon, okay? Since if you do so, the error will be occurring many times, okay? So multiple cases cannot use the same expression, again error will occur, okay? So these are the typical difference between switch versus if else ladder, right? Okay, so let's move towards what the go-to keyword is. So many programmers make use of go-to to take control of particular program where they want, but you know that a programmer who never used go-to is considered as a good programmer, okay? So the big problem with go-to, because the big problem with go-tos is that when we do use of them, we can never be sure how we get a certain point in our code, okay? These obscure the flow of control and definitely will make you a misunderstand that you will get confused and many problems would be occurring, okay? So just so far as possible, please avoid them, please skip them, okay? So I will also not taking these in our course, okay? Because if I do so, you will be hesitating to write it by the mean of other ones, okay? So the only programming situation in favor of using go-to is when we want to take the control out of the loop, means other than the loop. If you are out of the loop or if your execution is out of the loop, then you may use go-to keyword, but possibly avoid it, okay? So let's start it with summary. Let's see what we have learned up till this, okay? So what we need to choose one among number of alternatives, a switch statement is used, okay? What we need to choose one among number of alternatives means n number of alternatives are gonna be there and we choose among only one, okay? So the switch keyword is followed by an integer or an expression that evaluates to an integer type, okay? Integer data type, right? So the case keyword is followed by an integer or character constant, okay? So the control falls through all cases unless the break statement is given, means simply the break statement will terminate, okay? So it will terminate and it will execute the next instruction, okay? So the usage of go-to keyword should be avoided as it is usually violates the normal flow of execution, which will definitely you confusion, okay? Yeah, so these are the programs that you must practice and try. How would you build them? How would you compile them? How could you write them? How could you execute them? Okay, I will be telling you. If you have any queries and doubts regarding this, please let me know. So I will upload it on my Facebook page. Okay, so thank you guys for watching. This is only for today. We'll meet you in next session. Okay.